On behalf of the Dean, the Chapter, and the community of this cathedral, a warm welcome to our service of Evensong. A particular warm welcome to two groups of young people who are visiting from the Netherlands. I'm going to pronounce the name of your colleges really badly, but you are really warmly welcome. So we welcome young people from the Jan Tinbergen College and from the Homoras College. We hope you enjoy your service, your time at this service with us this evening. We also extend a warm welcome to those who are joining with us online, recognizing that we are a global community of Christians who gather in this place and via the internet to celebrate this service of Evensong in the season of Easter. We invite you, whoever you are, and whatever you have brought with you on your hearts this evening, to offer this time to God in prayer. This evening, our service is sung for us by our girl choristers.
Choir sings the appointed Psalm 89, verses 1 to 12. Please be seated.
Thank you. sixth chapter of the book of Deuteronomy, beginning at the first verse. Moses is addressing the Israelites as they stand on the threshold of the land that they have been promised. Now, this is the commandment, the statutes and the ordinances, that the Lord your God charged me to teach you to observe in the land that you are about to cross into and occupy, so that you and your children's children may fear the Lord your God all the days of your life, and keep his decrees and his commandments that I am commanding you, so that your days may be long. Hear, therefore, O Israel, and observe them diligently, so that it may go well with you, and so that you may multiply greatly in a land flowing with milk and honey, as the Lord, the God of your ancestors, has promised you. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your might. Keep these words that I am commanding you today in your heart. Recite them to your children, and talk about them when you are at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you rise. Bind them as a sign on your hand, fix them as an emblem on your forehead, and write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. When the Lord your God has brought you into the land that he swore to your ancestors, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, to give you, a land which is fine, large cities that you did not build, houses filled with all sorts of goods that you did not fill, hewn cisterns that you did not hew, vineyards and olive groves that you did not plant. And when you have eaten your fill, take care that you do not forget the Lord who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. The Lord your God you shall fear. Him you shall serve, and by his name alone you shall swear. Do not follow other gods, any of the gods of the peoples who are all around you, because the Lord is your God, and he is present with you, and is a jealous God. The anger of the Lord your God would be kindled against you, and he would destroy you from the face of the earth. Do not put the Lord your God to the test, as you tested him at Massah. You must diligently keep the commandments of the Lord your God, and his decrees and his statutes that he has commanded you. Do what is right and good in the sight of the Lord, so that it may go well with you, and so that you may go in and occupy the good land that the Lord swore to your ancestors to give you, thrusting out all your enemies from before you, as the Lord has promised. When your children ask you in time to come, what is the meaning of the decrees and the statutes and the ordinances that the Lord our God has commanded you? Then you shall say to your children, we were Pharaoh's slaves in Egypt, but the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand. The Lord displayed before our eyes great and awesome signs and wonders against Egypt, against Pharaoh and all his household. He brought us out from there in order to bring us in, to give us the land that he promised on oath to our ancestors. Then the Lord commanded us to observe all these statutes, to fear the Lord our God for our lasting good, so as to keep us alive, as is now the case. If we diligently observe this entire commandment before the Lord our God, as he has commanded us, we will be in the right. Here ends the first lesson.
The second reading is taken from the second chapter of the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. You were dead through the trespasses and sins in which you once lived, following the course of this world, following the ruler of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work among those who are disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the passions of our flesh, following the desires of flesh and senses, and we were by nature children of wrath, like everyone else. But God, who is rich in mercy, out of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead through our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up with him and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing, it is the gift of God, not the result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are what he has made us, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand to be our way of life. Here ends the second reading.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Thank you.
the anthem, The Song of the Tree of Life by Ray Vaughan Williams. Let us pray. In this Easter season, we rejoice in our Lord's resurrection from the dead and in his victory over sin, darkness, and the grave. We pray for the life of the whole Church, within the worldwide Anglican Communion, for Archbishop Justin, and today for the Diocese of Doornakal, in the United Church of South India, for its Bishop Padma Kodireka, and for his clergy and people. In our own diocese, for Rose, Bishop of Dover, for those who minister in the Elm Valley group of churches as they prepare to welcome a new priest in charge, for their whole life together in Christ. And we pray for the whole life and ministry of this Cathedral Church of Christ and within our community today for our Chief Constable and our close constables. Almighty and everlasting God, who formed your Church to be of one heart and one soul in the power of the resurrection and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, renew her evermore in her first love, and grant such a measure thereof to all your people, that our life may be hallowed, our way directed, and our work made fruitful, to the good of your Church and the glory of your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray for universal peace and justice in the Middle East, in Ukraine, and wherever war and conflict take their toll on innocent lives. And And let us pray for the hastening of that day when all may live confidently, with dignity, and free from want or fear. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace proceed, kindle, we pray, in the hearts of all the true love of peace, and guide with your pure and peaceable wisdom those who take counsel for the nations of the earth, that in tranquility your kingdom may go forward till the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us pray for all nations and peoples as we say together, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. As you leave the cathedral today, our stewards will be holding baskets to receive your donations. And there's also an electronic donation point for bank cards near the door as you leave. We ask you to be generous in your donation, as the music, mission, and care of this cathedral church costs almost £30,000 each and every day. We express our gratitude and thanks for your support. And now from the Red Hymn Book, we stand to sing hymn number 188.